Suns up against the Philadelphia 76ers. With two Hall of Famers, Doris Burke and Grant Hill, I'm Brian Anderson. Allie LaForce, our reporter. And here's a look at what's coming up for the Phoenix Suns. On Wednesday, they'll be matching up with Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat. And then Friday, they'll go up against Klay Thompson and the Dallas Mavericks.
And looking at the Utah matchup, that's a contest that I'll keep an eye on. That'll be the fifth time they take it to the floor, and they want to get off to a fast start this year.
A look at the 76ers starting group. Maxi and Oubre pair up at the one and the two. George and Martin looking to produce at the forward spots. And it's Drummond in at the center position, locking down the middle. And for the Suns, KD and Nurkic are the big man for them. Killer Bees on the wing, Beal and Booker the two and the three. And it's Jones in at the one. And it's the Suns to start out. We're excited to be here for opening day tip-off, Doris. It feels like the league is in a great place.
There is no doubt, BA, absolutely. To me, more talent in the league right now than potentially we've ever had before. And I don't just mean star talent. There's a depth of quality skill across the board. We know the shooting has revolutionized the game. It's going to be a fun year.
Now here's George. The kick out to Maxi. Martin with a screen on Jones. For three, Maxi. No good. And so it's Booker with it. He brings it up for Phoenix. And this is their first time matched up with Philadelphia this year.
And always a lot to find out when opponents haven't seen each other yet.
It's an interesting matchup. Two teams that don't know each other all that well. Separate conferences. We'll see which one can dictate the pace early.
So it's Philadelphia now. Coming off a Suns make. Jones against George. And it's Phoenix for the rebound. Jones up top. Outside Booker. Beal outside. Out of bounds. It'll go to the Sixers. Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Well, I had a chance to talk with head coach Mike Budenholzer. Facing off with Paul George tonight, I asked them what makes PG such a special player. Coach said, quote, well, he has a huge effect on the game. Paul can shut down your best scorer on one end and then put up 30 or 40 on the other. Tough to beat that. Paul George, he will have a lot to say about this one, guys.
Appreciate the report, Allie.
Boy, one thing you can say about Andre Drummond, he is so steady. Statistically, it's the same story every year.
Philadelphia shooting their first free throws of this game. And he can't get the first one. All right, Doris, what's kind of an unsung stat you appreciate about the Suns lineup?
Wow, they are so gifted offensively. So I'd have to say very good at getting to the free throw line. That's important. Very good at baiting defenders and putting your opponent into the bonus. That's big. Attacking into coverage. They get to spend plenty of time at the free throw line. It's an underrated advantage, BA.
Well, this was a big summer for the 76ers, Grant, trying to capitalize on their championship window with superstar Joel Embiid.
You're spot on, BA. Acquiring the talent that might allow him to save himself for the home stretch. Of course, last year's playoffs, he battled heroically, but ideally, they'd like him much closer to 100% come the postseason.
Boy, that is just tremendous concentration from Bradley Beal. Defense all over him, no problem.
Outside Oubre, Drummond up top. Maxi against Jones. To the middle. Here's Oubre. And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
Sometimes a player is born with a passer's mindset. He deals it with conviction.
Nurkic against Drummond. Nurkic passes to Booker. The rebound by Maxi. The Sixers trailing. Tries a 10-footer, and the shot goes in.
Ooh, a high motor in close to the rim. Maxi finding a window and converting.
Pass to Nurkic. Jones against Maxi. Here's Booker. The rebound by Maxi.
Boy, surprised he missed that. The defense just good enough to prevent that bucket.
Good on the shot. Maxi's got his second basket.
Sometimes the D likes to get physical with Maxi, but he has no back down in him.
Outside Durant. Shoots over George. That's good from Durant on the assist by Booker.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
They know that if this guy goes off, their chances of winning rise exponentially.
And timeout is called by Nick Nurse. A moment to rest and confer on the game plan. All right, now that we have a break, let's take a look at which teams capitalized from the line last season. Second, the 76ers.
Yeah, last season, this team had very few weak links at the free throw line, and that consistency added up to a sizable advantage.
And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in this first quarter. Maxi against Jones. Releases. Out of bounds. It'll be Phoenix's ball. And so it's Phoenix with it. They trail by one. Pass to Nurkic. On the wing, Durant. Five to shoot. And the layup is good off the glass. Durant's got six. The 76ers have gone 3 of 5 here in the opening quarter. In transition, here come the Suns. Booker can't get it to go.
Boy, a tough go for him in this quarter. You can see how desperately he wants to get things started. He just can't make a shot.
Martin with the bucket.
Yeah, Paul George is always about making the right play. What a pretty pass.
Booker attacking. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play.
That's what you call playing big. He just stays committed to the attack mode.
Well, major height disadvantage. He recognizes that and still able to score it.
Find the lane. Good shot.
Devin Booker is a two-guard, Doris. What's Book do that makes him special at that position?
I mean, so many things in terms of his skill. He's an elite shooter. He has become an excellent decision maker. He can get to the mid-range. He's a three-level scorer. There's so many things. But my favorite thing is watching this guy in an NBA Finals play with a broken nose, be hit repeatedly, and never flinch. His toughness and competitive edge is always there nightly, and I love that.
And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Phoenix.
Well, their hands resulting in plenty of steals in the early going, keeping the opposition there off balance.
Yeah, they've also been alert and active on the defensive end, creating turnovers and turning those into points on the offensive end.
Now here's Booker from the baseline. Paul George pulls down the board.
And just unable to get anything going tonight. I mean, his teammates have really bailed him out.
No good with the triple.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
Booker against George. Here's Nurkic. Yes, and it's Booker with the setup. Booker's got 3 assists in the game.
The D hasn't been quick enough to react to the ball inside. That's helped cause this run.
And so it's Nick Nurse calling timeout here. He'll take the opportunity to regroup. Phoenix making a switch here. O'Neal's checked in. What an honor it is to have Brittany Griner here tonight.
Oh, we're all so happy she's back here in Phoenix, a dominant force in the WNBA for over a decade.
pass to George. Back to Oubre. George, a screen on Beal. And here's Oubre from the arc. Phoenix grabs the miss. Here's Booker. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. Booker's got five.
They're really working the paint now.
Maxi surveys. There's the drive. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair. Talking about Tyrese Maxey, Grant, here's a guy who's improved every year.
Yeah, B.A. I mean, from averaging 8 as a rookie to 26 points during his breakout fourth year, Maxey has added to his game every offseason and turned himself into an elite scorer.
First one falls.
You really can't understate the energy Maxey brings to his game. Not just effort level, but his attitude and how that spreads to his guys out there.
Both free throws good from Maxey. Well, Grant, the Suns were swept in the first round last year. Are super teams a thing of the past, you think?
You know, perhaps, B.A. The Suns had KD, Booker, and Bradley Beal, but the constraints of the salary cap mean you end up a little top-heavy. The rest of the roster was tough for them to fill out.
Despite Joel Embiid missing more than half of their games, Grant, the Sixers still won 47 games last season.
Yeah, B.A., and lots of credit goes to Tyrese Maxey, averaging over 26 points a game. Philadelphia also had some good depth, and that really helped.
No good on the free throw. And Devin Booker is already one of the greatest players in Suns history, Greg.
Well, you could argue that Steve Nash still ranks ahead of him. He did win two MVPs with the Suns. But when it's all said and done, I think Booker will be regarded as the best.
Well, Bradley Beal is the epitome of being a triple threat. He can drive it, pass it, shoot it. The complete package on the offensive end, that defines Bradley Beal.
Now here's Beal. Nurkic inside. Here's Booker. Back to Nurkic. Yes! And it's Booker with the setup. Booker's got four assists now tonight.
Well, one thing you can always count on with Yusuf Nurkic, this guy's going to carve out space around the glass.
George with it. He's covered by O'Neal. From deep. George's shot is good.
You don't want to let him get into a rhythm from out there.
The Suns lead by four. Booker with it. What a tremendous game he played against Portland. The kick to Durant. Just five to shoot. And it's good with time running down on the shot clock. Durant's got 8 points.
Well, there's a reason Kevin Durant is finding the basketball late in the clock, because he's proven he can make those shots under pressure.
Pass to Maxey. Floats one up. Count the baskets. Maxey's got his third basket of the night.
This guy can do so much for you on the offensive end, and that is why his number gets called time and time again.
Now here's Durant. Lets it fly from 18. Kept alive. Nurkic's shot is good. He's got six.
I love how they've attacked the boards here in the first quarter.
Beal against Maxey. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw.
Second personal foul. Third team foul.
Philadelphia shooting their fifth attempt at the line in the game. A different look for Phoenix. Plumlee comes in for Nurkic. And it's Allen in for Beal. yeah. And here are the Suns now. It's a three-point game. Booker surveying the floor. From 10 feet away, Philadelphia grabs the miss.
Boy, with his shot not falling right now, it might be time to look in a different direction. See if you can get your teammates started.
Here's Maxey, plenty of space. O'Neal pulls it in.
Maybe he rushes that just a little bit, who knows, but he couldn't have gotten a better look than that.
Booker's shot is good.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
Maxey against Allen. Lowry with a screen on Allen. For three, Maxey. George outside. From downtown. Can't get it. He's now 1 of 4 from the floor. Phoenix leading by 5. And keeping us updated from the sideline, Allie LaForce.
You gotta love Tyrese Maxey's approach to the game. He said, quote, "I really have a simple life. I have this joy about playing basketball. I like putting in the work, so I'm extremely focused, extremely competitive, and I'm out here having the time of my life. I get to do what I love every single day, and it's a blessing," unquote. Brian, he's such a positive guy.
Yeah, he really is. Thanks for that, Allie. Now here's Booker. He's got 7. Screen by Durant.
2 minutes.
Back to Booker. Fades and shoots. And he gets it to go. Booker's got 9.
Yeah, they've done quality work on the offensive glass.
76ers trail by 7. There's a screen. Here's Maxey. And that one falls. His 5th basket in 7 tries.
And he's 5 of 7, getting into a nice rhythm offensively.
Lowry against Booker. Over Lowry. And he didn't get quite enough under that one.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
George passes to Lowry. Here's Yabusele. He's checked by Plumlee. George outside. Just 4 to shoot. Shoots over Durant. Top of the key jumper, no good. The Suns lead by 5. Pass to O'Neal. Plumlee, a screen on Gordon. Outside Booker. Up and over Lowry. Booker, no good.
It's impressive how they've overcome his cold streak tonight. Everyone stepping in to fill the gap.
There's a 4-second difference between the shot and game clock. Maxey against Allen. And Maxey, here we go. And it's Phoenix with a rebound. Durant's got 4 rebounds in the game. To the paint.
76-5. Paul George.
Phoenix shooting their 4th and 5th shots at the foul line in this game.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good. And Philadelphia making a change here. Both free throws good for Durant.
Boy, a really soft touch on display. It is a luxury to have a big man who can hit from the line at a consistent rate.
And so the first quarter is in the books. The Suns on top, up 7. Stay with us now as we get set to bring you quarter number 2. If you're just joining us, we played through 1 quarter in this one. And for Phoenix, guys, what jumps out to you stat-wise?
It's all about the strong inside-out game in the first period. It really helped them get some clean looks down low.
It is great when you can get that established early, because to me it opens up every other aspect of your game.
Here's George. Beal and Allen are out on the wing. Royce O'Neal is out there with Mason Plumlee. And it's Morris in at the one spot. That's who's out there for Phoenix. Counted from distance. Oubre's got his second bucket of the night.
When you look back at the history of the league, Doris, no position has evolved more than the center.
You know, B.A., that's a tremendous point, because you look at some of the best players in the league, they occupy the five spot. They're asked to do so much. Defensively, protect the rim. Be able to switch out and guard smaller players on the perimeter. Now you're being asked to be able to make shots from three. I mean, the big man's got a lot of responsibility in today's game.
And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line. It goes on Mason Plumlee. Philadelphia shooting their sixth and seventh free throw shots in the game. And falls for him. Both good from the line that time. And it's Beal with the ball for the Suns. They lead by four. Inside. Slam dunk by Plumlee.
Terrific handle right there by Beal. Comes off the pick with his head up, looking for his teammates.
George outside. Back to Jackson. Allen against Martin. Was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a three-point play here.
There are nights where it's impossible to stop Paul George. He is such a strong guy who knows how to convert through these plays.
Jones, he's checked in for Phoenix. Good from George. Doris, we've heard Paul George get a lot of praise from the next generation of NBA talent.
We sure have, and it's easy to see why, Brian. This guy is fundamentally sound. He does a little bit of everything, can shoot with range, can get off the bounce. His game is so polished and smooth, worthy of emulation.
Jackson surveying the D. Pass to George. Over Allen. George's shot is off.
This guy just can't find his rhythm, and you look up at the scoreboard, they absolutely need his productivity.
Allen, the pass to Jones. Down low. He can't hit that time. Ooh, nice D from George. And stolen by Jones. Allen on the wing. To the inside. Martin outside. Over Jones. Martin with the bucket. Martin's got 5 points.
Looked like some confusion defensively that time. Left him wide open for a nice look on the jumper.
Beal against Oubre. Allen outside. Plumlee a screen on Oubre. Here's Beal. Pass to Plumlee. Allen outside. Shot clock at three. Three-pointer O'Neal. Nice start for him, sinking his first shot.
He drops yet another dime, just facilitating this offense like a maestro.
Here's Yabusele. Kicks it out to Jackson. The three! O'Neal pulls it in. The Suns lead by four. Pass to Beal. It's hauled in by Oubre. Philadelphia has gone one of two from deep in the second quarter. Jackson finds Martin. Back to Jackson. Beyond the arc.
And so it looks like it'll be Philadelphia ball. A quick break, and we look at our 2K leaderboard for three-point shooting last season. Fifth, Phoenix.
Last year, they were so good at generating open looks from distance. That's why their three-point shooting was so high.
Some changes for Phoenix. Bowl, he's checked in for O'Neal. And it's Booker in for Allen. And so it's Nick Nurse calling timeout here. He wants to review the game plan. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Martin with a screen on Jones. Down low. And stolen by Bowl. Here's Jones. And it's rejected. And now the Sixers on the break. Martin with the ball. Beal picks him up. 2 points. That one goes. Assistant. George has got eight.
Boy, nice job by Paul George to make himself available. Gets to his spot and gets it off quickly.
Beal outside. George with a steal. They've got numbers. On up the court. Oh, deflected. And stolen by Booker. Bull down low. He's covered by Oubre. And that one's good. Bull.
Devin Booker, not a guy who's going to just hunt out his own shot. If you're open, he'll find you.
It's George on the wing, hounded by Beal. Bull against George. Shakes off strong D and gets to the bucket for 2 points.
And despite the size mismatch, getting a little aggressive down there in the paint.
Some guys just relish the challenge. Find a way, and he does.
Jones against Jackson. There's a screen by Bull. Five on the clock. Jones. And the Suns getting another bucket right there.
Now Jones, very smart. Always takes what the defense gives.
Jackson against Jones. Outside Oubre. Here's the three. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. It's Beal on the wing. Shoots over George. Ooh, nice D from George.
It's one thing to prevent the layup. It's another to do it without fouling. Just terrific defense.
The dunk with a foul on top of it. So strong.
Making sure of it with the two-man slam, B.A.
Yeah, I don't blame him. With the score this tight, you cannot take a chance here. Durant, he's checked in for Bowl.
Assertive as he needed to be in the first quarter, but now he's taking a more head-on approach and getting himself to the line.
Outside Durant. On the take, Durant, and he lays it up and in. Durant's got 12 points.
Kevin Durant just understands how to find the open spots on the floor. His scoring line, proof of him getting to the efficiency we always look to.
Here's George. The Suns clear it. Durant's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Outside Jones. Pass to Booker. Plumlee, a screen on Martin. For 3, Booker knocks it down from distance. And now it's a 6-point Phoenix lead.
You have to honor Booker's range. This guy can get flowing from the 3-point line.
George outside. Puts up a 3. Kevin Durant with a rebound. Durant's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Durant earning those 2 points.
This guy is cooking right now. He is leading them on the offensive end as they remain in front here.
76ers trail by 8. Now Jackson, no points yet. Outside Oubre.
Jackson with a screen on Booker. And here's Oubre from the arc. Drains it. Now he's 3 for 5.
Shut out from beyond the arc in the first quarter. He's now got 2 for the game.
And Booker's got the ball here for the Suns. Inside. And it's Martin with the rebound. The 76ers have gotten 7 of 15 shots here in the second quarter. Jackson against Jones. Elbow shot on the way. Durant pulls it in. Durant's got his 7th rebound here tonight. To the middle. Here's Beal. Can't get it to drop. Some solid defense from Martin. 76ers trail by 5. To the paint. Yabusele. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
I'll tell you, that vertical ability he has puts him in select company in NBA power forwards. May not have great size, but boy, he plays bigger than it.
Jones, the pass to Durant. Durant draws the double. Back to Jones. And a miss there on the triple. Philadelphia has gone 2 of 6 from distance here in the second quarter. Back to Martin. Over Booker. Misses off the left iron. Phoenix leading by 3. Inside. Here's Plumlee. Basket counts. Plumlee's got 6 in the quarter.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. Yeah, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Outside Oubre. George outside. Puts the move on, and the layup is good. George has got 12.
Oh, my goodness. Paul George under duress of exceptional defense. No problem.
Oubre against Durant. Shoots over Oubre. Outside Jones. Fires the 3, and that comes off the assist by Durant. Durant's got 3 assists tonight.
Oh, the defense has to stay attached to him on the perimeter.
Doris, in terms of assist-to-turnover ratio, Tyus Jones normally leads the league.
B.A., this guy is such a steady hand at the lead guard position. Tyus always makes excellent decisions, plays within himself, and plays mistake-free basketball.
Pass to Booker. There's the triple. Rebound by Philadelphia.
And we haven't seen them pound the ball inside and draw as much contact this quarter.
Here's George. From 13 feet, down it goes. 14 points for him.
I'll tell you, despite this guy's strong play in this period, they're still behind. Someone else has got to step up.
Plumlee, a screen on Oubre. Shot on the wing. Outside for Booker. Beal surveying the D. On the wing, Durant.
Kevin Durant has absorbed a big-time scoring role everywhere he's been. This guy is so special offensively.
George outside. They double-team George. Martin right side. Jackson down low, working on Jones. Jackson gets the bucket.
Reggie Jackson has got the willingness to convert on the interior. Nice touch right there.
Outside Booker. For 3, Durant. That one's good. Give the assist to Booker. Booker's got 6 assists now in the game.
And the defense is really allowing them too much room on the perimeter.
Martin with a screen on Jones. Jackson down low, defended by Jones. Jackson against Jones. Jackson can't get it to go. Shot and game clock separated by 5. Booker, the pass to Jones. Plumlee, a screen on Jackson. Down low. Another shot. And it's laid up and in by Plumlee. And now a 9-point Phoenix lead.
But you like that he shakes off that rocky first period and knocks down a shot. Nice.
A step back shot. Unable to get that one. And so it's the Phoenix Suns with a 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. Great shot selection right now, keeping the game simple and getting high percentage looks. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
I'm here with Nick Nurse, and Coach, I saw you imploring your team to pick it up. Where do you need to be better in the second half?
Well, we're not very good offensively right now. I think we're taking some okay shots, but we got to be a little bit more patient and keep moving it around a little bit. Need multiple paint touches rather than just one. So we just got to do a little bit better job of getting off it and relocating a little bit.
Patience is a virtue. Thank you, Coach.
Allie, as always, thank you. We'll be back right after the break for the third quarter here on 2K Sports.
Thank you for joining us. Getting right to the story, things are going well for the Phoenix Suns.
When you outwork your opponent like this, getting those extra shots, it just shows your guys want it more, man.
Yeah, talent is one thing, but there's no replacement for hustle and effort.
And now let's take a glimpse at some of the games on the upcoming schedule.
You know, for Phoenix, like most teams right now, they're optimistic. We'll see how they handle the first couple of games.
Yeah, everyone starts out undefeated. It is a hopeful time of year for everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Now it's time to head back over to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
If you just join it in, one half is in the books, one half to go. You know, Kevin Durant has really been making it happen here, guys.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far, unstoppable.
So it's Maxey with it. He brings it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. They trail by 9. So on the floor for Philadelphia, Oubre is at the 2 with George playing the 3. Andre Drummond is out there with Caleb Martin. And it's Maxey in at the point. Well, Grant, you often hear about how smooth Paul George's game is.
Yeah, I'll tell you this. Young players could learn a lot by watching his footwork. His timing, his ability to find the space he needs, it's just tremendous.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
He misses the free throw.
When health has been there for Paul George, he has been one of the great two-way guys in the league. Very capable scorer and can take on tough assignments.
And he sinks the second.
You cannot give Paul George these extra chances. This guy is deadly from the free throw line throughout his career.
Oubre against Beal. And he can't extend the lead to double digits.
Oh, man, he can't get anything to fall. You can feel his frustration.
He is trying to shoot his way out of it. And it might be better for him to pass the basketball at this point.
There's the strength training coming into play for Maxey.
He's made all of his free throws to this point, 3 of 3.
One shot.
Phoenix leading by 5. Outside Booker.
Outside, 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 outside.
Ooh, against inside resistance. Booker still good.
Well, a guard has got to come with physical intensity on the interior, and Devin Booker does just that.
Oubre, a screen on Booker. They double-team George. Pass to Maxey. Shot clock at 6. There's a screen. Three-pointer. Knocks down the triple. Maxey's got 19 points.
Ooh, the range of Maxey is pretty impressive. He is consistent from beyond the arc.
To the inside. Here's Durant. It doesn't go for him. Ooh, nice D from George. Here we go. The Sixers on the break. Martin, the pass to Maxey. Launches it from deep. It's hauled in by Beal. The Suns leading. Pass to Booker. And here's Durant. Three-pointer. Drummond grabs the miss.
Boy, as slow a start as you could have, just 1 for 4 from the field, they're struggling.
To the middle. And stolen by Durant. Now here's Booker. The rebound by Maxey. Maxey's got 5 rebounds tonight.
Not how they hoped to start this half. 1 for 5, brick after brick. Let's start building the building.
Oubre passes to Martin. Drummond, the screen on Jones. Inside, Maxey finds Drummond. And the jam by Drummond.
Showing off some mobility there. When Drummond rolls like this, he's hard to stop in pick and rolls.
Back to Booker. Pass to Durant. Fires the 3. Rebound by Philadelphia. Maxey's got his 6th rebound on the night for the tie. And there's Oubre. That one's good on the assist from Maxey. Oubre's got 10 points in the game.
80% shooting to start the third, 4 for 5.
Booker, the pass to Nurkic. Jones with the ball. There's a screen by Nurkic. Launches a 3. Philadelphia grabs the miss. Martin's got his 5th rebound in this one. And let's send it over to Ali LaForce.
When you have an MVP talent in his prime, the focus has to be on winning the title. The Sixers' Joel Embiid said, quote, "The only thing I care about is winning. That takes a lot, and everybody has to contribute. I'm always going to believe in myself. I love the guys that we have. We are going to go and fight every single night."
Great perspective there. Thanks, Ali. And so it's Jones who brings up the ball for the Phoenix Suns. Beal outside. Jones feels it out to the inside. Count the basket and the foul! That one on Martin.
That's just tremendous concentration by Devin Booker. He takes the contact, doesn't let it bother him. Now he'll get an N1 opportunity.
Well, Grant, if you talk about consistent top-level scorers, Devin Booker is near the top of that list.
Yeah, and going back to the 17-18 season, Devin has averaged at least 25 points every year. Book can create his own shot and finish. It's hard finding guys who can do both.
That free throw good from Booker.
You love that Devin Booker now has experienced postseason success, because there were some who questioned his greatness. Now that conversation is over.
And timeout is called by Nick Nurse. He wants to make sure everybody's on the same page. And always interesting to look back at last season. These were the NBA's best transition teams. 5th on the list, the 76ers.
They would just push the ball at every opportunity, even when defenders had already gotten back.
George passes to Drummond. Back to George. Outside Maxey. Let's the 3 fly. Durant pulls it in. The Suns have gotten just 25% of their shots to fall since the half. 2 for 8. Outside Booker. The 3 is up. And that comes off the assist by Durant. Durant's got 4 assists in the game.
Well, that's his 2nd 3 of the game. 1 in the first half, 1 here.
Martin with a screen on Jones. Maxey against Jones. Pass to Martin from outside the arc. Drills it from deep. Martin's got eight.
That's how you up the ante. Come right back at him.
And you would expect nothing less from these two, taking pride and making plays.
Here's Nurkic. Now here's Durant. George defending. Booker against Martin. In deep. Booker gets it to go.
Well, they're calling his number time and time again, and he is delivering.
76ers trail by three. Outside Oubre. And he dunks it down.
This guy's a super quick leaper. Oubre doesn't need much time to get off the floor.
Here's Booker, and he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
Second personal foul.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Suns.
Yeah, what stood out to me was their passing. They moved the ball effortlessly and have been able to find those holes in the defense.
And you also have to love the way they've gotten out and run in transition. A ton of good chances tonight simply from being willing to run the floor.
That free throw good from Booker.
Yeah, just an offensive machine. Booker generates points consistently, night in and night out.
Both free throws good from Booker.
The way he's shooting free throws tonight, you simply don't want to put him there.
Martin outside. Pass to Maxey. Outside Oubre. The three ball. Durant pulls it in. Durant's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two. It's going to go on Paul George. And Doris, when you think about Kevin Durant, certainly a prolific scorer, but that's not the whole story.
What I love the most, I think, B.A., about Kevin Durant is how much he loves playing the game of basketball. His availability is never in question as long as there is some measure of health. The work he puts in consistently, anyone who's ever seen his routine, teammates, coaches, front office staff, they are in awe of the commitment to his craft.
Free throw is good from Durant. And Kevin Durant is arguably the greatest scoring forward ever. What makes KD so incredible, Doris?
B.A., this game better go into triple overtime if I've got to list everything that makes this guy special. Size, elite shooting, ability to handle the ball at 7 feet, put it on the deck, get past, finish in traffic, rebound. You need me to guard every single position on the defensive end? I can do that. I could go on all night. How much time we got, B.A.?
One of the all-time greats, Kevin Durant, the Slim Reaper. Maxey against Jones. Outside Oubre. Six on the shot clock. Drummond to screen on Booker. Down low. It's stolen by Nurkic. Booker off the bounce. And Booker with the jam.
Woo-hoo, that was an explosive move by Devin Booker. Decks it and finishes.
George scanning the floor. Maxey on the wing. Back to George. The three is up. Philadelphia with another miss.
He didn't make them pay for that weak defense, but they just can't rely on him to miss those kind of shots.
Back to Booker. Outside Jones. There's a screen by Nurkic. Outside Jones. There's a screen by Nurkic. Jones misses. 76ers trail by seven. Pass to Maxey. Now George, guarded by Durant. Fires for three. Martin with the bucket. Martin's got six here in the quarter.
Well, there you see Paul George as a facilitator. He can create his own, or he can get somebody else open.
Outside Durant. Booker finds Durant. Yes, and and it's Booker with the setup. And the Suns lead by 7.
Man, this is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Well, that three-point shot just gives you so much room to operate on the offensive end.
Here's George. The Suns clear it. Outside Jones. Some solid defense from Drummond. 76ers trail by 7. For 3, Maxey. And it's Phoenix for the rebound. Durant's got rebound number 11. He takes it in. Oh, KD striding in for the finish.
KD is a force of nature. Sensational dunk at the rim.
Jones against Maxey. Martin outside. Stolen by Jones. Pass to Nurkic. Beal against Oubre. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Now Booker. The 3. Rebound by Philadelphia. George has got 5 rebounds in the game. Martin against Durant. It's George on the wing. 15 points in the game. The Suns lead by 9. The baseline Jay is on the way. And Booker the bucket on the assist by Beal. Beal's got 4 assists now tonight. Martin outside. Back to Maxey. Here's the teardrop. Oh, Nurkic with the block.
Boy, that's great anticipation by Jusuf Nurkic. He saw what they were trying to do and snuffs it out.
Booker with it. Oubre picks him up. Outside Jones. Nails it from 3. Jones has got 10 points in the game.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
Drummond to screen on Jones. For 3, Maxey. Rebounded by Nurkic. Nurkic has got 5 rebounds tonight. Here's Booker. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. Kelly Oubre picks one up.
Well, free throw attempt numbers indicate just how difficult someone is to guard. Booker certainly in the hard to check category.
And he makes a first.
And really strong at the line since the break.
Some changes for Phoenix. Plumlee's checked in for Jusuf Nurkic. O'Neal comes in for Durant. And it's Allen in for Jones. Both free throws good from Booker.
You know, seeing an uptick in his trips to the free throw line, really, since we came out of the half.
Maxey against Beal. Maxey, that's good. Maxey's got 8 points in the quarter.
Man, that's just fantastic use of the mid-range by Maxey.
Plumlee, a screen on Lowry. From about 16, they get it back. Outside for Booker. Shoots over Maxey, and that one hits the back iron. And so it's Maxey with it. He brings it up for Philadelphia. It's a 14-point game. It's off to L.A. after this game, where they'll face the Clippers. That'll be their 2nd of 3 games total on this road trip. Here's Gordon, and he gets that one. Gordon's got his first points of the game. Phoenix leading by 12. Now here's Booker. 30 points in the game.
Oh, Booker
shrugging off the contact.
He's putting them to the test this quarter, attacking every chance he gets.
Booker against Lowry. Martin outside. Pass to Lowry. To the paint. Here's Gordon. That's good. And so Lowry with the assist.
Well, defensively, to me, you've got to do a better job communicating once the screen comes.
Beal outside. Screen by O'Neal. There's the three. He's off on that one. Devin Booker. He's feeling it tonight. He's been the driving force for the Suns. He's been an offensive force. Now with over 30 points after the quarter. Back after this. And now let's take a listen in on head coach Mike Budenholzer.
Just relax. We're in good shape. Keep looking for each other. Keep cutting hard. Everybody look. Take care of our defense. More pressure. More activity.
That's Mike Budenholzer running through the gambit of areas where he feels they need to excel.
Yeah, most of all, coaches asking them to be 100% engaged. Give it your all, and then let the chips fall where they may.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works, or if it's more of the same for the first three quarters. Booker is the two, with Allen playing small forward. Royce O'Neal is out there with Mason Plumlee, and it's Jones in at the point guard position. That's who's out there for Phoenix. And there's the foul. It'll go on Tyus Jones.
First team foul.
That's foul number two for him. Gordon against Allen. With the teardrop. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two.
Second team foul. Second team foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws good from Gordon. The Suns lead by 10. Pass to Booker. On target from about 13 feet. Booker's got 34.
Someone who utilizes that mid-range part of the floor to extreme efficiency, Devin Booker.
And here's Gordon from the arc. Gets the three ball to go.
Wow, you don't see him left alone very often. And, of course, he makes good use of it.
And here's Booker. Allen outside. Gordon pulls it in. 76ers trail by 9. Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Here's Yabusele. Pass to Gordon. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
First person of foul. Third team foul.
First free throw is good. Both free throws good from Gordon. And so it's Booker with it. He brings it up for the Phoenix Suns. At one point, they led by 16. Let's go with a three. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Plumlee. Two minutes gone by here in the fourth. 76ers trail by seven. Lowry surveys the D. Gordon with a screen on Jones. And here's Lowry from the arc. And it's Phoenix with the rebound.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Down low. Here's O'Neal. The shot that time, not on target. Some solid defense from Martin. Pass to Lowry. Here's Jackson. Booker defending. To the middle.
Yeah, you never want to let shots at the rim go uncontested.
Down the first one. Paul George, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Oubre comes in for Jackson. That misses, so he splits the free throws. And one of the game's best shooters, Doris, Grayson Allen, can really stretch the floor for you.
B.A., his presence on this particular roster is so significant because of what they can do around him. Yes, you have to stay connected to him on the perimeter because he can flat beat you from distance, but you also can't foul him. He is consistent at the free throw line, and he's very capable off the bounce. Grayson Allen is a more well-rounded player than he's given credit for.
Another miss by Philadelphia.
Well, two long-range bombs in the first, but that's stalled out right now.
Pass to Allen. Plumlee, a screen on Gordon. Allen attacking. Banked it in off the glass. And it's an 11-point Phoenix lead.
You're not going to get stops against him unless you give an effort.
Allen against Gordon. Oubre, a screen on Allen. For three, Gordon. O'Neal pulls it in. O'Neal's got four rebounds now. Inside. Knocked away. It's stolen by Oubre. Gordon outside. Plumlee brings the double. Gabuselli lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
Showing great awareness and quick decision-making. That's how you handle getting double-teamed.
Plumlee, a screen on Oubre. For three, Booker. Rebound by Philadelphia. George has got six rebounds here tonight. Pass to Gordon. They double him with Booker. And here's Lowry. Just five on the clock. To the inside. Yabusele, look that.
Well, so great when your offense produces a shot that close to the rim. The rest of the work becomes easier.
Now here's Booker. Plumlee, a screen on Oubre. For three, Booker. Devin Booker for three.
And they keep attacking from the three-point range here in the second half.
76ers trail by 10. George with it. From the arc. Nails it from beyond the arc.
Well, Paul George says, I can answer with my own big-time three-point shot. Go to work, PG.
Jones, the pass to Plumlee. Pass to Booker. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
First personal foul. First team foul.
And he drops a first.
A different look for Phoenix. Yusuf Nurkic, he's checked in for Plumlee. Durant comes in for Allen. And it's Bradley Beal in for Jones. Both free throws good from Booker. And we're starting to see some big contracts for NBA head coaches, Doris.
Well, BA, whether we are talking about player contracts or coaches' contracts, the cost of business is the cost of business. And coaches, to me, earn every penny. Because what happens when teams underperform? The first fall guy is typically that head coach. I have zero problems with the salaries.
Yeah, just another shot in Maxey's arsenal. He becomes harder and harder to defend.
And that one misses. Phoenix leading by seven. Here's Durant. Durant, so effective inside.
Well, this is what makes Kevin Durant maybe the greatest all-around scorer in the game today. Equal proficiency from every spot on the floor.
For three, Maxey. And the 76ers get it back. The shot by Drummond, no good. For Phoenix, they've got 5 out of 10 shots to drop here in the final quarter. Pass to Nurkic. Booker against Martin. Jacks up a 3. Rebound by the 76ers. Drummond's got 5 rebounds tonight. To the paint. Here's Maxey. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up. It goes on Kevin Durant.
And just a very well-built guard. You know, Maxey is so hard to slow down around the rim.
And he makes a first. It's both from the stripe. Here's Booker. Beal outside. This one for 3. Paul George pulls it in. George has got 7 rebounds in the game. Softly drops in the floater. George has got 20.
Boy, how pure a shooter is Paul George? That form is simply on point.
Yeah, simply stated, you have to take care of the basketball, and they don't on that possession.
Jones, he's checked in for the Suns. '76ers trail by 5. Left side, Maxey. Outside, Oubre. Maxey passes to Oubre. The rebound by Devin Booker. And Booker's got the ball here for Phoenix. At one point, they led by 16. Nice shot by Durant.
Well, you get a sense of how locked in Kevin Durant is. The defense not going to alter his approach.
Outside Maxey. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
Shooting 2.
That free throw's good from Maxey.
free throws good from Maxi. The Suns lead by five. Here's Jones. Pass to Durant. Oh, George with a steal! Durant, no good. Philadelphia's gone 2 of 6 so far in the fourth. Up top, Maxi. Pounded by Beal. The shot's good. Maxi's got 29.
You know, Maxi's willing to play a secondary role, but he can also take charge when needed.
On the wing, Durant. George defending. Durant against George. Nice shot by Durant. Durant's got 32 points.
Well, you love his effort level, right? Particularly when it's winning time. He is going for the finish.
Drummond, the screen on Booker. George against Booker. And he banks in the layup. George has got 7 points for the quarter.
Well, Paul George has got a tight handle, right? The zig, the zag, and his way through the porous defense.
Jones, the pass to Durant. Booker with it. From deep three-point land. Drummond grabs the miss.
Given his range, you'd expect him to capitalize on that opening.
Oh, they get a hand on it. Beal against Oubre. Outside Jones. There's a screen by Nurkic. And Jones, good for three. And the Suns lead by six.
Building confidence in that deep ball. One from distance in the first, two in the second.
And so it's Nick Nurse calling timeout here. He wants to make sure they're purposeful with the game plan. Check in with Allie LaForce.
I had a chance to find out what Nick Nurse was discussing with his players. And a big reason their team is down? The three-point line. Coach saying in the huddle, we have to battle on the perimeter. They're outplaying us from the arc. Guys?
Great work, Allie. Thanks. On defense, the Suns. 6-point lead. Here's Maxi. Out to Oubre. 4-3. And it's Phoenix with a rebound. Pass to Durant. Rebound by Philadelphia. George has got 9 rebounds in the game. Boy, he's getting it done. Unloads from 13. And it's Maxi missing. Phoenix leading by 6. Down low. 3-on-3. Here's Martin. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. It's going to be on Bradley Beal. First one at the line is good. Both.
He showed a lot of composure that trip to the line. Now it's almost a one possession game.
Maxi against Jones.
2 minutes remaining in the game.
Outside Durant. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
You simply can't fight on the shot fake, but Kevin Durant makes that a tough task.
Thank you. So the first one drops, and that puts him up five.
And one of the best things about Kevin Durant is he simply locks in on exactly what's in front of him at the moment. If that means working at practice, that's what he does. If that's competing at a high level in the game, that's what he does.
So he gets them both, and it's a six-point ball game.
Well, you like when a guy calmly steps up, knocks down the free throws, exactly what you want.
Maxey against Jones. Maxey passes to Martin. Right side Maxey. Six to shoot. Somehow scores the layup in traffic. Maxey's got 18 points now here in the second half. Here's Booker. And the Suns miss again. 76ers trail by four. George passes to Martin. The kick out to Maxey. 1:14 left in the fourth quarter. Comes up empty from 19 feet out. And it's Beal with the ball for Phoenix. At one point, they led by 16. To the middle. And there's Durant. That one's good. On the assist by Beal. Durant's got 36 points. And the 76ers shooting 47% since the fourth quarter started. For three, Maxey. Kevin Durant pulls it in.
When you're not in rhythm with the three ball, why do you keep firing from there?
And it's in after a nice bounce off the right iron. Durant's got 38 points.
They have a relentless mentality, even with the game in total control.
This is a textbook example of playing the possession and not the score. This team is doing a great job continuing to execute.
Tyrese Maxey lives for these moments. Loves coming through in the clutch.
Second technical foul. Third team foul.
Hits the first one, and that makes it a seven-point lead.
Tyus Jones, such a quietly efficient and productive guard. What I like about this young man, he always plays to his strengths.
And he's unable to get the second one. And here are the Sixers now. Pass to Maxey. Oubre on the wing, pounded by Beal. For three, Maxey. And he buries it. And now they trail by just four.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
Well, the best players, to me, deliver night after night after night. So as long as he's hot, keep riding it.
He gets the first, and that puts him up five. He's off on the free throw, unable to get the second one to drop. Time called here. The 76ers decide to talk it over. They trail by five. Turning here to our analyst, what elements become the primary keys at this point?
The strategy is simple. Get a quick score and foul right away.
Everybody has got to be in the exact perfect position defensively, and execution has got to be on point.
Seventeen seconds left in the game. For three. The shot, no good. And he commits the intentional foul.
Yeah, no choice but to foul in that situation. Although, that's not the guy you want to send to the free throw line.
drops the first one, and that increases the lead to six. Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one. For three, Maxi. That shot missing. So Phoenix wins it. I'm sure they would have preferred a blowout victory, but a win's a win.
And so true, but you have to credit the crowd for giving them such a big boost toward the end. It really kept this team's energy high.
And now let's check in with Allie LaForce with the player of the game. Allie.
Kevin, this was a huge statement win for this team. How satisfying is it for you?
It was fun. It was fun. We came out and played hard. Guys played together. And this is all that I expected, man. I'm glad that, you know, we was able to get the win tonight. We're looking forward to the next game.
Thanks so much, Kevin. Guys.
All right, Allie, thank you. That concludes the first game of the NBA season. For Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Doris Burke.